In this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about creating floor plan in Procreate. We'll cover everything from drawing to scale and working with external reference, to designing detailed floor plan, enhancing it, and even a creating lighting layout. I'll share all the tips and tricks to make navigating Procreate a breeze even as a beginner. Stay till the end, you will master Procreate and make your design workflow more fun and intuitive. First, let me show you quickly the simple interface of Procreate. Let's get started. First, we will begin by setting up the base scale of the drawing using our grid lines and scale ruler. You can download these for free from our website. Choose your paper size based on your floor plan size. For example, a 15 by 8.5 meter floor plan fits well on an A4 grid at a 1 to 100 scale. For larger plans, use A3. To begin, we'll import the grid lines to Procreate. In the gallery, tap the Import button and select the A4 metric grid lines. The grid lines is open in a new canvas. You can adjust the grid lines opacity to make it more subtle. Now, let's insert the scale ruler. With Transform mode on, you can readily move the ruler. As you can see, the ruler's dimensions match the grid lines precisely. The scale ruler includes both 1 to 100 and 150 scales. 1/8 and 1/4 for imperial scale. When the transform mode is on, you can move the ruler or rotate by dragging the green handle. If you move the ruler outside the canvas and exit transform mode, reactivating transform mode will crop anything outside the canvas. Simply tap the screen with two fingers to undo this. Be careful not to adjust the ruler size, as it is not scalable. Again, undo this by tapping the screen with two fingers. Now, let us insert and scale your floor plan to match the 1 to 100 grid lines. You can start designing your floor plan directly on the grid lines, but in most cases, you'll need to scale an existing floor plan or site boundary to use as a reference for your new design. Let me show you how. First, insert the floor plan from your folder or image library. When resizing, make sure the uniform option is selected. This keeps the proportions of the floor plan consistent, which is essential for precision. For this tutorial, we'll use these bed dimensions as our reference. You can use any clear dimension from your floor plan as a guide. I'll adjust the floor plan's opacity. This makes it easier to see the grid lines underneath and align the floor plan's dimensions to the grid lines. When you compare the grid lines and ruler dimension, 1 meter is equivalent to 1 thickened grid box. Adjust the corner handle or pinch to resize the floor plan until the bed's dimension matches the grid box or the scale ruler measurements. Now the scaling is done. You can see the bed width and the length now match the dimensions represented by grid boxes. Next, we'll turn on Drawing Assist feature, which helps us draw straight lines easily. Follow these steps. Turn off the drawing guide since we have our own grid lines. There are two ways to turn the assist on and off, so you can easily switch between drawing straight lines and freehand curves. You can enable or disable drawing assist under the layer options menu. For quick access, I've set up the modify button to turn the drawing assist on and off. And now you can turn the assist feature on and off just by tapping on the modify button. Retracing the floor plan is easy in Procreate. First, we'll create a new layer so that any new lines we draw are on a separate layer. Move the layer to the top. You can also rename the layer. I will lower the opacity of the original floor plan. This makes it easier to see the new lines. You can also lock the floor plan layer to prevent any accidental adjustments. Choose a brush and start tracing the floor plan. Turn on Drawing Assist. This is how I trace the outline of the wall. Make sure the boundary is closed and choose Automatic Select tool. Tap inside the boundary. You can drag your Apple Pencil left or right to adjust the threshold of the selection. Finally, drop the color in. Depends on the complexity of the shapes. You can also use the Rectangle Selection tool to create the rectangular shape selection and fill it with color. If you find our video helpful, don't forget to click the like button. Let me quickly trace out the outline of the walls. To draw an arch line at the door, turn off the Drawing Assist, draw a curved line, and hold it longer with the pencil. Procreate will smooth out the line. Similarly, hold it longer if you want to convert a line to a straight line. Finally, drop in solid color to all the walls. Since I'll be making changes to the internal layout later, I'll just trace the exterior walls for now. And there you go, the existing floor plan is traced. Before inserting stamps from our brush set, make sure the dynamic brush scaling feature is turned on. Turning on this setting helps keep the brush size consistent on your canvas. To establish the scale, use the stencil scale rulers from our basic brush set. Use your pencil to point to the crossing of grid lines. Adjusting the brush size tab on the left until the stencil scale ruler matches the grid lines. There you go! The stencil scale ruler now matches the grid lines. The brush size 40% is the scale you will use to insert all other stamps. Choose the stamps you want to use from the brush sets. Set the brush size tab to 40%. Place the stamp on the canvas. Move it to align with the grid lines. You'll see if it matches the dimensions exactly as stated in the brush set. If you have created a new layer for each stamp that you inserted, you can edit the stamps easily. Make sure you're on the right layer and tap on the Transform button. You'd be able to move and rotate. You can also flip the stamps horizontally or vertically. To resize uniformly without changing its proportion, select the Uniform option, drag the corner handle. If you need to adjust its height or width only, tap the Freeform tool. Drag any handle to adjust the width and height independently. Let's see what happens when you're not creating a new layer before inserting new stamp. When stamps are inserted on the same layer, they merge into a single image. This means you'll need to cut out the stamps before moving them. In this scenario, I can use the Rectangular Select tool to edit one of the stamps. Or use the Freehand Select tool to draw the selection boundary freely. It is important to know these editing tips when the stamps are on the same layer, as you will need to merge the layers when you hit the layer limit of your device. The number of layers you can create in Procreate depends on the size of your canvas as well as your device's capabilities. Check it out here! As I start designing the floor plan, I begin by drawing the new partition walls for my new layout. Insert the furniture stamps. To show the order of the objects, I'll erase the overlapping line. Use the Rectangular or Freehand Selection tool to select the part you wish to erase. Then, select the layer you want to remove line from. Use Erase tool to erase. I want to extend the TV console to fill up the entire wall. I will just to duplicate the console layer by sliding to the left and tap duplicate. Now I have a copy that I can move into position below the original. I use the rectangle selection tool to select the part I wish to delete, and use the eraser tool to erase. Since they're supposed to be one item, I will merge these two layers together. All our stamps are perfectly scaled and include real-life dimensions, making it easy to create precise floor plans just like using CAD. We've done the research to ensure every stamp matched the common market sizes, so you can design confidently without any guesswork. With over 1,600 ready-to-use elements, our Procreate Interior Toolkit allows you to create professional floor plans effortlessly. And it doesn't stop there. You can also design lighting and ceiling layouts, electrical plans, and even HVAC systems, all with professional quality stamps. Designing layouts in Procreate is intuitive and allows you to sketch and get inspired at any stage of the process. And our Procreate Interior Toolkit lets you combine the creativity with precision, which is essential for effective spatial planning. Plus, working on your iPad makes it incredibly flexible. You can edit designs effortlessly anytime, anywhere, whether you're at home, on site, or meeting with clients. I'm using the ruler to measure and draw out accurate size of kitchen counter. Stay till the end to see how the toolkit can simplify utility layout design and take your workflow to the next level. Our brush set also includes a wide variety of door and window stamps to choose from. Now we're done! Now it's time to export it out. Exporting is easy in Procreate. Go to the Actions menu, under Share tab, choose your preferred file format. If you want to crop the canvas before exporting, go to the Actions menu under Canvas and tap on Crop and Resize. Adjust the border to fit the floor plan. If you plan to print the floor plan to scale, make sure to keep it at the original A4 size canvas. Export to the floor plan in PNG format. Now you can find your floor plan in your folder. You can easily shade the floor using our floor texture brush. To start, you can either reinsert the PNG file you created earlier or merge all your layers into one. This allows you to quickly select a floor area outside the stamps. Use the automatic select tool to highlight the floor area. You could adjust the selection threshold by moving the pencil left or right. Once the area is selected, grab the floor texture brush and start painting. If you find the pattern too light, simply duplicate the layer for a darker pattern. Similarly, you can use our texture brush to add marble texture to the kitchen counter. You can use Procreate's built-in brushes to add color to the furniture stamps. This gives your floor plan a more artistic look. To add openings to walls, lower the wall layer's opacity so you can see the window and door stamps. Leave a wide variety of door and window stamp for you to choose from. Position them the way you want. Erase the wall where needed. Then restore the opacity. To create a lighting and ceiling layout, switch the floor plan to dark mode to highlight the lighting. Simply invert the colors of your floor plan. Next, add stamps and luminance colors to your drawing. We have over 150 lighting stamps, all to scale, with a variety of sizes and dimensions to choose from. Using the LED brush, you can mark areas for cove lighting easily. Finally, use Procreate Soft Brush to add lighting effects and simulate brightness. To create an electrical layout, just insert the electrical or smart home symbols we've designed. Move them into place. Editing on an iPad makes it easy to adjust the placement quickly and conveniently. We've also included a legend for easy reference. For the HVAC layout, we've got everything you need from air conditioners and heaters to fans. Use our special brushes to draw the piping, helping you clearly see where everything runs in your design. Position and align the ceiling fan in relation to the furniture layout. You can also draw out the ductwork with our special brush. Simply duplicate the layer for a thicker line weight. And we're done. We've redesigned this floor plan to a completely new layout. Even covered how to create the lighting, electrical, and HVAC layouts. Want to start creating? Check the link down below to access to our Procreate Interior Toolkit today. If you have any questions about this video or designing in Procreate, drop a comment below. I'll be sure to reply promptly. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tutorials like this.